Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cuts Reactions and my name's Greg. And I was going to play some Frank Zappa. I ended up getting over there in a roundabout way, but in any case, I ran across this song, which I always dearly loved, Cosmic Debris. And it's, you know, it always struck me as funny at the time, you know, because of all the hazy cosmic jive going around, you know, and I mean, don't get me wrong, you know, I was doing my stuff, you know, but yeah, there was always somebody willing to sell you Nirvana. And so anyway, let's go ahead and listen to it. I don't know when this was recorded or, you know, what the configuration of the band is. Jean-Luc Ponty is on violin, but that's about all I know. I didn't recognize the other people. But like I say, there's not enough information about it out there. So we'll just go ahead and play it. And I don't own copyright, so let's listen to the man himself.
The mystery man came over and he said, "I'm out of sight." He said, "For a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me." But I said, "Oh, dear brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Oh, dear brother, you waste your time on me." Well, the mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo, but he told me right then, when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo, he said, "You might not believe this, little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too." And I said, "Oh, dear brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? Don't you waste your time on me." We'll be right back. I've got troubles of my own, I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and ram it up your snout. But I've got a crystal ball, he said, and he held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right. I wrapped the newspaper around my head so I looked like I was deep. I said some mumble jumbles then, and I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and pocket watch and everything else I found. I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said, the price of meat has just gone up, and your old lady has just gone down. Well, yeah, brother. Who are you jiving with that cosmic debris? Now, who are you jiving? Don't you know you can make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste none of your time on me.
Like I say, I love it. I love it. It's so funny. Of course, you know, nowadays you can go ahead and spend $3,000 or $4,000, you know, to go sit in a sweat lodge and attain nirvana. I don't know. You know, I guess you can pay Gwyneth Paltrow, you know, hundreds of dollars for some shit and cream or whatever that will cure what ails you, you know, snake oil salesman. But, you know, that's not to say that I haven't done my own stuff and, you know, certainly spent plenty of time in sweat lodges and a lot of time in hot springs, you know. So, like I say, you know, I'm not discounting that at all. It's just people want to sell you shit, you know. People want to make money on, you know, giving you some spiritual education or whatever. So, anyway... on that note, I'll let you guys go. I'll be back in a few minutes and we'll play something else. In the meantime, hit like, subscribe, and we'll see you then. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.